And now, around the world and around the corner, it's the David Bowers Awards, bringing the best in indie music to millions of listeners worldwide with your host, The David Bowers. We've got a fantastic lineup of guests, our entire crew here at the Asylum, and me. I'm John Bon Jovial. And now, here's the voice of indie music, The David Bowers.
Well, thank you very much once again, the legendary John Bon Jovial, folks. Welcome aboard to you, and I hope you're ready to stick around for some interesting music. We got a new twist in the show today, something we've never done before, and we really enjoy breaking new ground here on the show and doing little extra things, different things for emerging indie artists. I think you'll see what we mean in just a few minutes. But first, we have a tune we'd like to play for you. It's a guest from a few months ago. Mr. Larry J has a brand new track just out today, and we're going to play it for you right now. It's a killer song, let me tell you. Here's Larry J with a killer song.
Sometimes heartaches can be like weeds. If you let them grow, it's hard to make a leaf. You must get them out from the roots. Yeah, you gotta dig deep, or they'll be back within a week. To kill these kind of weeds, I need a song. Put my headphones on and they're gone. I play it loud and I go out. Anytime I need something strong to kill these kind of weeds, I'll play a song, a killer song. If the root of your heart is buried, good melody, you'll make bad feelings go. It's an instant therapy that's free, and with each note, a new branch of a good vibe grows. To kill these kind of weeds, I need a song. I put my headphones on and they're gone. I play it loud and I go out. Anytime I need something strong to kill these kind of weeds, I'll play a song, a killer song. Kind of weeds, I need a song. I put my headphones on and they're gone. I play it loud and I go out. Anytime I need something strong to kill these kind of weeds, I'll play a song, a killer song.
And there you have it. It's a killer song. I hope you listen to the lyrics of it, because that's really the strong point of the song. And I think the understated accompaniment music sort of helps you accentuate that. Larry J, who was on our June 20th show, if you'd like to go back and listen, Blog Talk Radio, of course, has all of our old shows archived there. You can go back and listen to his interview and a couple of more of his songs from our June 20th show. Larry J, it's called A Killer Song, and we're going to find out John Bon Jovial's opinion right now. John Bon Jovial, what'd you think?
Well, you know, obviously it's a killer song, huh? That's good.
Well, I'm glad you're on board.
He takes an excellent, he does an excellent play on words. And, you know, when you think, well, man, that's a killer song, man. You know, you expect to have it be this hard-driving rock and roll, screaming guitars, pounding drum beats and things like that. But, no, he does a very nice job and pulls it off okay.
I thought so, too. And we thank Larry very much for passing that song on to us and letting us debut it here on the David Bowers Awards. Moving right along, we've got a couple of announcements to make. And the first, of course, is our friends at our flagship FM station, WRFZ, FM 106.3 in Rochester, New York, is going to be doing a Labor Day weekend marathon, a radiothon, a fundraiser. As you know, if you've been hanging around us for any length of time at all, WRFZ in Rochester is a free FM station, which means you don't get a barrage of commercials every 5 minutes on there. So it's a pleasure to listen to. They have talk, they have music, and of course the best part of all is they have the David Bowers Awards on there. So we want to be sure and to remind you of their show and their Labor Day weekend radiothon, where they'll be attempting to raise money to support the station. And they'd like your help also, if possible, whatever you have, you know, as much as you can afford to donate will be greatly appreciated. And it is tax deductible, by the way, John.
Well, I was just going to mention that if you are outside their listening area of Rochester, New York, which is quite a beautiful market, you can also get WRFZ online at rochesterfreeradio.com, and you can listen anytime, 24 hours a day, no matter where in the world you are. Just go to rochesterfreeradio.com and go to that phone number that's on their website. Make that donation, because these guys really do a nice job, and they're not going to allow these silly car dealers to scream bloody murder at you, and they're not going to allow the lawyers to come on and say, "Were you crushed by a steamroller in an accident? Well, call us." They don't do that stuff. They really do cater to the community, and it's a beautiful thing.
Exactly. They are a throwback to the old days of radio and media, when they were truly a servant of the people of their market. This station serves the people of Rochester. They serve them with talk. They serve them with music shows that they couldn't get anywhere else. And they really do a bang-up job, and we support them 100%. And I also know that the program director there, Brian Judah, is going to be doing – he's going to be attempting, along with his co-host, Richard Slosh Dyson, will be attempting to broadcast on the air straight for 24 hours from midnight September 5th until midnight September 6th. That ought to be really hairy and funny the closer they get to midnight September 6th, because I've done those radiothons before, and you can get really silly when you lose sleep. But they will be attempting to do it, and they've told us they are going to be locked in, and the management will not let them out for 24 hours until they bring in the donation. So it's all for a great cause, to improve things at the station and serve their community better. And we hope you will support them as we do. And we wish them all the best. Want to also take a second to remind you that Frank Palangi, the upstate New York indie rocker, had his home burned down, which included his studio. He's really strapped, and he's trying desperately to rebuild. A GoFundMe page, which is available. You can get the information off of his, off his Facebook page, Frank Palangi, or any of his other sites. Just Google Frank Palangi, and you'll find his sites. So let's get right going. I told you we have something new and a little bit different in our quest to serve the emerging indie artists market. And we have an artist standing by who is a drummer. Now, this will be the first time we've had a solo instrumentalist come on here and just perform their talent, just show you what they do. His name is Nick King, and he's a drummer, and we're going to listen right now to Nick King, track one. We'll be right back. There you go. He calls himself Nick King. That's a track of his drumming, and he's actually serving a dual purpose. We're going to bring him right on in here right now, but he's serving a dual purpose, not only showing you his talents and what he does, but he's also kind of auditioning for a job. He's looking for a gig, and I'm sure he's going to tell us how you'd be able to get in touch with him and set up an audition for him to work with you, perhaps. Nick, come on in and say hello.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, you are my man. Great to have you with us. And I love the concept. This is something we've never done before. Had a solo artist come in here and basically audition for a job on our show. We thank you for coming by, for sharing your drumming with us. And tell us a little bit about Nick King.
Well, I'm from West Virginia. I'm 25 years old. I've been playing drums for almost 10 years, and I think I found a band now, and I have a gig in Iron City, Tennessee, September 25th, with Sugar Rose. So I'm hoping this will be my band.
I gotcha. Great. I'm glad to hear that. Now, I understand you're probably also available for studio sessions, too.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, kind of thought maybe you would be. Now, tell us a little bit about, you said you've been drumming for some time now. Tell us about your experience, how you've developed, how you've moved forward to get to where you are today.
Well, I was 16 years old. I was with my mom and my sister, and we went to a music store, and she bought me a drum pad. And when I had a little sister, she liked like One Direction, Justin Bieber, that kind of stuff. So my very first song was by One Direction, and then later on I got a drum set, a Pearl, and I started learning the Cars, the Beatles, and so on. And then 18, I found my first band with my cousin and his friend. We played fairs and festivals for about 2 years. Then I was solo again for another year. Then 22, I found Crossover, and that was the one that got me everywhere. I was on magazines, interviews, major platforms. You name it, I was there. And now I just quit that band 3 months ago, so now I'm just doing my own thing till somebody picks me up. And I've been talking to Susie, which is Sugar Rose, and she's been looking for a drummer, and she was like, I got a gig September 25th. She was like, you in? I said, hell yeah.